Now, for a person with no relationship experience, I sure do give a lot of relationship advice. When my friend asked me, Shri, how come you know so much about relationships when you've never been in one? I only smile and say, coaches don't play. On that note, good evening, Toastmasters and my dear guests. Who are some of the famous coaches that we have seen in Indian sports? Of course, we have Pulela Gopichand, who has been a coach for PV Sindhu and Saina Nehwal. And there's Kapil Dev, Rahul Dravid, and lots of them. They are few of the finest ones we've seen or heard of. But have you observed one thing? Coaches don't play. They don't play the game. They don't make on-field decisions. They don't run or hit the ball or catch the ball. They don't field. They don't play the game. Coaches are basically leaders that help people build on their strength, recognize their weaknesses, and improve on their skills. A coaching style of leadership is characterized by partnership and collaboration. When a leader behaves like a coach, there is no hierarchy, command, control. There's only collaboration and creativity. Now, for this project, I had to take up an analysis to identify which style of leadership suits me the best. And I wasn't surprised to know that coaching leadership was my suited style of leadership because the path I chose itself is called effective coaching. Now, for the largest portion of my life, I have been somebody who wants to be the student of the year or the employee of the month, but also couldn't help wondering what it's like to be on the other side of the table. The person with authority and responsibility, with power that makes people to listen to them and follow them. It is only when I joined Toastmasters that I learned an important secret of leadership, that you don't necessarily need to hold power or authority to be a leader. You see, leadership cannot be taught to you. You're either born with it, or you observe the leaders around you, comprehend and adapt it into your own style. I observe different leadership styles exuded by different Toastmasters and imbibe those qualities that I appreciated in them the most. The first thing I did when I became a president here was I thought to myself, what is it that I was expecting from my leaders? And the moment you understand that aspect, you'll be able to deliver better. I strongly believe that most Toastmasters are coaches. They manage to lead even without holding a title or a position. They are the people who see potential in you even before you see it in yourself. DTM AK Prabhakara, MU Bhatt Sir, Dr. Vijay Shree, Toastmaster Supreet are some of the coaches that I have learned a lot from observing their styles of leadership. After observing them, I came up with the top three things that are important in the coaching style of leadership. Number one, these type of leaders create more leaders. Coaches don't tell you what to do. They don't spoon feed you or hold your hand along the way. They create an environment and give you a platform to explore and identify your own skills. For the coaching style of leadership to work out, the most important prerequisite is that the team member demonstrates the willingness to learn and improve. It excels when individuals have not yet realized their full potential. There's a famous saying that says, if you give a man a fish, you feed him for a day, but if you teach him fishing, you feed him for a lifetime. When I was the president, some of the members here were a part of my team. Amok, Sai, Udank are some of the people who are in my team. And let me take Toastmaster Sai for an example. He was a sergeant at arms and he was told of what are his duties to do. It was his willingness to learn and grow that made him step up and take additional responsibilities, like recording meetings, editing them beautifully and uploading them on social media. As a coach, I only acted as a facilitator for him by encouraging him and connecting him to the right resources. And if you've observed now, he also was the Vice President Public Relations recently and did a fabulous job in taking the social media frontier of our club to the next level. And if you see, he is a leader now, encouraging people and supporting the new upcoming team and creating more leaders around him. Second most important characteristic is the art of appreciation. They say when a person feels appreciated, they perform way more than what is expected out of them. Positive statements always foster a high level of personal gratification. A leader must always ensure the team is high on morale and boost their confidence by appreciating the efforts taken by them. And I personally believe that this was one of my biggest strengths as a leader, because I always followed upon my team, gave them the right feedback, and appreciated their steps or efforts at every step. Today, when I look at Toastmaster Amog as the president and the way he carries out his responsibilities, handles his teammate, it's a fulfilling experience, especially to observe how he motivates and appreciates and encourages his team. Thirdly, one of the third most important characteristic that I want to talk about is that one-on-one experience is the most important. Coaching leadership requires a continuous dialogue between the teammates and the leader. The teammate and the leader work closely, mainly on the improvement and development of this teammate. The fact that somebody has vested interest in your success is not only motivating, but it boosts the commitment and loyalty. I can take example of Udanka for this. Right from the time he was in my committee till now, I have been closely following up on him and invested time in guiding him across the leadership frontier. But the best thing about him is that he's a self-actualized person and does not really need to be told what to do. Rather, he just needs to be pushed to adopt the right responsibilities in the right circumstances. So let me summarize quickly the top three characteristics of a coaching leadership style. Number one, coaches don't play, they create more leaders. They help you realize your full potential. Coaching involves the art of appreciation that fosters a higher level of personal gratification. And number three, the one-on-one attention to teammates boosts their confidence and loyalty. My dear Toastmasters, by understanding this style of leadership, I understood one important thing, and that is that you don't need to hold a title or a position to be a leader. It's never about the role. It is about the goal. The goal of preparing an individual for a future by building their skills. You don't have to be on the field making decisions at the game. You don't have to be the person with the bat or the person with the ball, because that's all about the players. Why? Because coaches don't play. Thank you. Back to you.